Yes, sir. The county fire department currently uses a VHF paging system to notify volunteer firefighters whenever there's a call in their assigned district. That technology has been beginning to be unreliable. The system itself has some age on it. And one of the primary reasons we stayed on the VHF system when we moved to 800 megahertz for the public safety radio system was simply the fact that at that time there were no 800 megahertz pagers on the market. As technology has improved and now 800 megahertz pagers are available, they provide some increased functionality and most importantly, improve reliability and clarity whenever a call goes out. So we feel like now that they're available, we have tested one to make sure that it would meet our needs, and feel like that would allow us to address the issue of some of the firefighters not receiving the notifications and allow us to make sure that we're providing the best possible service to the citizens when they do call and have a freeze. So with that, I would mention that this is a budgeted item, and this price does reflect cost savings of about $19,000 over what we originally budgeted through some negotiations we did with the vendor. So with that, we would respectfully request authorization to make that purchase and be glad to answer any questions you might have.
Any questions for Mr. Ty?
The question I had, this is a wholesale change. We can't purchase this product for a troubled area we have. Continue to use the VHF?
No, sir, because there's not really a spot that the way the system works is we have a control station that's on one tower, and then we have repeaters everywhere else. So right now our main problem is in the south end of the county. But 12, 18 months ago, we were having the same issues in the north end of the county. So these are sporadic issues. So we could, in theory, phase it in, but that would not be a very efficient operation. And I would not do that because he's not here to defend himself, but I think Danny Weeks and the 911 center would not be very happy with me because that would increase, whereas this is actually the way we're going to implement this is actually going to provide a little bit of a lesser load on the work that dispatchers have to do. But having two separate systems, you need to go with one or the other. So we can stay with the VHF and continue trying to patch it and fix it and make it work, or we can go with this new technology and hopefully see the benefits and not have other recurring issues.
Thank you.
I'm assuming there's over 100 of these?
Yes, sir.
Do we have a use for the old VHF?
So the old VHF pagers, this quote did, that vendor did offer us for, so our fleet, we have Miniature 5, which is an older model, and then the next model, the most current model from Motorola is the Miniature 6 pagers. So the Miniature 6 pagers, they will give us a $50 trade-in should we choose to take that. My feelings are that we would be better off to declare them surplus. I think we could probably get more through gun deals or something of that. So there more than likely will be some surplus value to them, but that'll be after we get these in and get them working and figure out the best way to get a little return.
Any other questions for Mr. Ty? Thank you, Mr. Ty.
Okay, Mr. Ty, I'll entertain a motion.
Motion to authorize staff to purchase the new pagers from Mobile.
Do we have a motion to authorize staff to purchase the new pagers from Mobile Communications? Do we have a second?
Second.
Do we have a second? Any discussion on the motion? Hearing none, we'll call the vote. All in favor, signify by aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, like sign. Hearing none, the motion carries. Agenda item.